Hey guys, BeckBay13 here with another review. This time it's of the Destroyer Dome. Now, this was probably Hasbro's most controversial product of all time. Next to the Easy Bake Oven, but that's beside the point. So, what this is, basically, is you need the special spin track that comes with the set. And it pretty much circles around the stadium. One top hits the other. Whichever one sinks to the bottom first loses. You pick it up. There's a hole on here. It falls out. You can put a stand on it. So that's the concept of it. The reason why this was probably one of the most controversial ones was that the bays will spin for a couple seconds depending on what launcher you use. I know with my bay launcher setup, I got one going for like 1 minute before it died, which was pretty cool. But besides that, at the same time, I want to say it's useless for tournaments because you can't have a fair battle in it because if it just wouldn't work because by the time your opponent launches their other top, yours is probably just going to be sinking to the bottom. So while it's useless for competitive play, it's actually kind of fun to mess around with. So, as I just went over the stadium itself, I'll kind of show off the contents now. So what you get, two specially designed launchers, which have pretty kind of cool designs on there. You get two collector card product code things, and no, I'm not going to show you the back with the code because I play the game. You get two assembly tools. You get two bays, which was a weird choice for bays, but it's Cyclone Herculeo with this special spin track, with F, Spiral Fox special spin track, and D. And so you can actually make the normal bays. They did give you the 130 and 105 spin track, so you can make the normal bays without the giant dome tracks. So, putting back the stadium here, I guess I can do a test launch with this, so I'll just show you what each one of them's like. Just getting my launcher set up so I can get it in. Each of the tracks kind of have a different play pattern, and there actually is a Toys R Us set with barrier areas that gives you two different other tracks. So, let's go. I'm gonna do that again because that was probably not the best launch that could have been. So let me just get my grip set up. Try that one more time. So got a Spiral Fox with the gripper spin track. This is the more V-cut attack type track. As you can see what I mean when it was controversial, but that was, I could try to get it going. Let's see. There we go. So it kind of just circles it, and then it dies. Wow, that was perfect timing. Yeah, that was one take, so give me credit for that. So, like I said, you can't really do tournaments in it, but it's kind of fun to fool around with. Because there's things you can do with it that you can't do in normal stadiums. Like, this is one of my light wheel bays. This was one of Takara Tomy's first releases for MFB when they came with plastic wheels. So, you can kind of just mess around with it. Since it's plastic in the first place, it'll kind of go around. I got it to work better a couple of times if I can get it now. There we go. Or not. Let's try that one last time. And you can actually do normal battles in it too, which is kind of fun. There we go. Since the entire wheel is made of plastic, you can just do that. And the battles don't really last that long, but you can do normal battles in it. I'll give you an example. Just grab two random bays, Firefuse Darkhelm, and Archer Felenic. Like I said, it It's kind of hard to do and it doesn't last long, but... You know what I mean? It's just stuff that you can't do in a normal stadium, which is... It's fun, so... I got it because I wanted a fun stadium to kind of use around with. The spin tracks are fun to fool with. The bays are great for collection. I love the clear wheel sharpens of paint on them. But besides that, like out of collection and for fun, I guess if you want it for collection pieces, like I said, for fun, you should definitely get it. If not, if you're looking for an official stadium, don't buy this because it's nowhere near to an official stadium. I did get this on clearance for like $27-ish at Target. So if you are going to get it, I'd recommend looking for it on sale. So that's about it for the Destroyer Dome. Thanks for watching, guys.